Hello, and welcome to the tutorial on how to update your home and community-based services online attestation form. My name is Dan Goldstein, and I will be guiding you through this tutorial. This tutorial is designed for providers who have already submitted their initial attestation and need to update it to reflect their ongoing progress. This tutorial will cover the following topics. Part 1, logging back into the online form. Part 2, updating your attestation responses. Part 3, adding attachments, and part 4, how to submit your attestation. If you want to advance this video to a specific topic, the timestamps are as follows. Part 1, logging back into the online form, 1 minute. Part 2, updating your attestation responses, 4 minutes, 46 seconds. Part 3, adding your attachments, 6 minutes, 39 seconds. And part 4, how to submit your attestation, 10 minutes, 15 seconds. Let's get started with our first tutorial, logging back into the online form. The first thing you need to do is have a few things ready to use for your login. First, make sure you have your license or HFID number available. If you are not able to find this, find the confirmation email you received when you submitted your initial attestation. This email confirmation includes your license or HFID number as shown on this slide. Next, you will need the email address you used when you submitted your initial attestation. Your confirmation or submission was sent to the email address you entered into the form. So, again, you can use that email confirmation to verify the email address needed to log into the form. Once you have this information ready, open a browser and go to the following URL, https://edocs.dhs.state.mn.us/lfserver/secure/dhs-7176-eng. This URL will bring you to the online attestation form, which has the Minnesota Department of Human Services logo in the upper left-hand corner, and then this title in the middle, Home and Community-Based Services Provider Attestation. Scroll to the bottom of the page and click on the button in front of Update a Submitted Attestation. Once you click on the button, notice that additional fields and information appear at the bottom of the page. Click your cursor into the field labeled License or HFID and then type in your license or HFID number. Then click your cursor into the field labeled Email Address and enter the email address that you use for the setting that matches the license or HFID number. Finally, click on the Lookup button. If your license or HFID number is not accepted, you will receive an error notification. If you are not able to proceed to the next page, recheck that your number and email match the confirmation email received after submission. If you are still unable to enter a valid number and email combination that matches the one used in the initial submission, please send us an email. Do not start a new attestation. Send an email to hcbs.settings@state.mn.us. That is hcbs.settings@state.mn.us. Use the subject line, Updating Attestation Assistance Needed. Please include your provider ID, email, submission date, provider name, the setting address, city, phone number, and the provider service type at the setting. Once you have your number, go back to the online attestation form and click your cursor into the field labeled License or HFID and type in your license or HFID number. Then, click your cursor into the field labeled Email Address and type in the email address used for the initial attestation form. Then click on the Lookup button. If your license number and email address are recognized, a new button that says Start Attestation will appear in the lower right-hand corner of the page. Click on this button to update your attestation. You will now be on the next page of the online attestation form. This is the Provider Information page. You will notice that this page is completed with the information you submitted for your initial attestation. From this point, you can continue through the attestation form. We will now move on to updating your responses in the online attestation form. If you have just logged in, you will be starting on the Provider Attestation page on the online HCBS Provider Attestation Form. Use the Previous and Next buttons or the Table of Contents drop-down menu at the top of the page to navigate the form. For purposes of this tutorial, I'm going to use an example of how to update the response for question number 10 in the form. Using the Table of Contents menu, located at the top of the page, let's navigate to question number 10. First, click on the down arrow on the far right-hand end of this box so that it will open up the drop-down menu with the Table of Contents on the form. Go ahead and click on the line Date and Residential Q10, Q11. This will take you directly to the correct page in the form. When you get to this page, you will notice the information you already submitted for your initial attestation. To update this information, simply click on the button that reflects your current status. For example, for question number 10, if you had indicated that you do not yet comply for your initial attestation, then that button will already be checked. If you now comply, simply check the button in front of the line that says Comply. If you are selecting Comply, be sure to also complete the information about the documents you will be submitting. For example, for question number 10, you would indicate the page numbers for the relevant documents. You can navigate the form and update your responses to reflect your current status. When you are done updating your responses, you can click on the Submit Attestation button at the end of the form on the last page. However, you need to add an attachment before you exit, which we cover in the next section. Okay, so we've shown you how to log in and how to update your responses. Now, let's walk through how to add attachments. Let's pause for a moment and talk about why and when you will be adding attachments. Most of the questions in the attestation form require you to provide documentation to show you meet the new requirement. So, you will need to add this documentation as attachments to your online attestation. You can add attachments at any time. However, attachments will only be saved when you click on the Submit Attestation button. Attachments will not be saved if you click on the Save and Exit button. At this point in the process, since you are updating your initial attestation, you should only use the Submit Attestation button. Let's jump in and look at the details. First, navigate your way to the Attachments and Save or Submit page of the form. Remember, you can use the drop-down menu at the top of the page to jump right to this page. Before you add your attachments, it is a good idea to have them saved somewhere you can easily find them on your computer. Although the documents you previously uploaded will not be on this form, they are in your file and do not need to be resubmitted. Once you have your documents ready, go ahead and click on the Attach Required Documents button. This will bring you to a new page within your browser. From here, you can add files by accessing your computer. In the left-hand column, there are several buttons. We will begin by clicking on the Add File button. This will open a dialog box of your file manager. Depending on your computer and your file manager, your screen may be different than what is in this video. Regardless, you should be able to navigate your file manager to find the first file you want to attach. In my example, I am selecting a file named Example, Funds and Authorization Form. If you have more than one file in this view, you can select multiple files at this point. Once you have selected your file or files, click on Open in the dialog box. The dialog box will close and you will now notice another smaller dialog box. The file you just selected will be in this dialog box. In my example, the file Example, Funds and Authorization Form is in the dialog box. To complete the process, go ahead and click on the Add button in the lower right-hand corner of the dialog box. To add more files, repeat this process. When you are done adding your files, click on the Finish button at the top of the left-hand column. This will bring you back to the Attachments and Save or Submit page of the attestation form. The documents you attached will be in the List of Attached Documents section on this page. Now, you need to assign a document type to each document you attached. To do this, click on the down arrow of the drop-down menu next to your document and select the appropriate document type. In my example, I am selecting Funds and Property Authorization or Money Management Form for my example Funds and Authorization Form document. Remember, you must select a document type for each attached document. When you are done, you must select Submit Attestation at the bottom of this page in order to save these attachments. If you select Save and Exit, these attachments will not be saved. Let me repeat that. If you select Save and Exit, these attachments will not be saved. So, as I mentioned at the beginning of this section, only use the Submit Attestation button as you are updating your attestation. We will be covering how to submit your attestation in the next section. We have touched on a few elements of this topic already, but let's focus now on how to submit your attestation. The key thing to keep in mind is that because you are updating your initial attestation, you should only click on the Submit Attestation button. Do not use the Save and Exit button. Let's review how to submit your attestation. You will need to add all your attachments to demonstrate that you meet the new requirements. The details on how to add these attachments was covered in the previous section. Once you have updated your responses and added your attachments, you are ready to click on the Submit Attestation button at the bottom of the form. You will receive an automatic email confirming that the system has received your submit attestation. You can also come back to the form and update your responses, and you can submit your attestation again. We encourage you to update your attestation with your ongoing progress. Thank you for taking our Updating Your Online HCBS Attestation Form tutorial. If you have additional questions about using and navigating the online form, please send them to hcbs.settings@state.mn.us. That is hcbs.settings@state.mn.us. Should the need arise, we will add additional tutorial topics in the future. For more information on home and community-based services, visit our webpage at mn.gov/dhs/hcbs. Thank you.